Hello and welcome to the Lake Placid 2023 FISU World University Games. It's day five of the competition and the first day of speed skating featuring both the women's and men's 1,000 meter sprints, the equivalent of a running mile. We're here at the fantastic James Sheffield Olympic Skating Rink, home of the infamous Miracle on Ice. We're starting with the women's 1,000 meter finals, and all the athletes here today will sprint 2.5 laps of this 400 meter oval in a race against the clock for a place on the podium. The conditions are looking absolutely fabulous. Beautiful sunny day, a little bit chilly out here. But as you can see, the ice is looking very, very slick, very slippy. They are racing against each other, but the key thing here really is the time. So you can have a pair, if they're super fast, both making the podium. So we're looking for the clock rather than who crosses the line first in each of these pairs. So Iga Vodashik gets the speed skating competition here in Lake Placid underway, coming around the first bend, and this is where the skaters generate their speed, gliding through the straights to try and maintain that speed. But effectively the bends are where you build up your potential energy. Switching to the outer ring. So coming into the back straight, getting a signal from the coach to go back into the inside. Putting down the benchmark time here through the final bend. And through the beam, and a 1:21.79 set with a split time of 32.99. So that's our benchmark for the rest of the competitors. So Smidzik from the University School of Physical Education, representing them and Poland, up against Korea's Kungil University's Kim Dong-hee. Can this Korean impress? Kim Min-jo sitting in third spot at the moment with a time of 1:25.25. Well, it's not too bad for the pair of them. 0.34 over for the pole, 0.54 over for Korea's Kim. Switch sides now. Smidzik going to the outer ring, Kim Dong-hee on the inside ring. Can they keep this power up now? Still in touching distance.
That time for Smidzik, 31.11. And for Kim.
Well, the pair of them can break the top three here, but it's Kim who's setting this track alight at the moment. Crucial final 300 meters here. Got to power through this final bend. You can see there, she's really working hard around that outer ring. Top time is safe. Is the podium safe? Well, Kim Dong-hee goes up into second position. Kim Dong-hee up into second spot. And from the Takasaki University of Health and Welfare, Japan's Onodera Rui. Finished first in the 1,000 meter sprint at the Japanese Student Championships last week, so he's on form. Pair number 13, unlucky for some. But keep an eye on this pair. Coming up to the first split, 1891, the time to beat. They're in touching distance. Well, marginally ahead in between the pair, Onodera. Switching to the inner track. 48-80 the split. This is going to be quite close. In touching distance, just under a second off the time. Can Onodera build up some speed through the final two bends? Trying to glide, maintain some energy, coming into the final bend. Onodera switching to the outside, trying to power down, put everything into this last bend, build up the speed to glide over the line. Top time safe, that's for sure. She's gonna make the time. This is close, oh, it's just outside. Fourth place for Onodera Rui. Didn't quite challenge her, 1:23.74. Just 8 thousandths off making the podium. Not quite enough in the end for Onodera Rui, just outside the medals. So pair 16, Takahashi from Japan up against Park from Korea. Chukyo University and the Korean National Sports University represented here in this 16th pairing of 18. 1891, the split time to beat. Now we are looking very hot here. Park has smashed the time by a third of a second at the first split. Now has she got the legs to hold on? But keep an eye on Japan's Takahashi as well. Going through the transition. Plenty of power left in the legs of both of these young athletes. 48-8 has still been beaten, and these two are both challenging for the podium.
Takahashi at 29.93.
Final transition. Park inside the time, challenging for the gold medal here and the title in the 1,000 meter sprint for the women in speed skating. They are so close here. This is going to be an electric finish for the pair of them. Well, they are both in podium positions potentially. In the end, Park just lost a little bit of time to fall into second place. The pair of them knock out Kim and Antasova. As Park moves into second position, and Takahashi moves in to third.
Time is good enough to put her into second place.
Well, very impressive times from the pair of them. So the final pair in the women's 1,000 meter sprint here at the World University Games in Lake Placid in 2023. 1,000 meter sprint challenge from Germany's Josephine Heimel and Korea's Kim Min-sun. Kim inside the time by nearly 0.4 of a second, but Heimel not far off. off either. 0.2 slower than the best set time. Can they challenge for the podium? Both of them in with a shout. So the Korean gets the bell first, the split at the 600, still inside the time, way inside the time, in fact, 0.6 of a second. Does she have the legs, Kim Min-sun, to hold on to this out of the penultimate bend, going down the back straight? Kim Min-sun is challenging here. Relaxed through the final bend, but working hard. Pressing really hard. Track record being beaten already by Iga Vojtasik. Kim Min-sun crosses the line in first place and smashes the track record to take the gold medal here. Josephine Heimel, in the end, blew up like a lot of the athletes in the last 300 meters, but what a way to finish for Kim Min-sun, who absolutely obliterates the track record. A new track record set here in Lake Placid. A 1:20.46. Kim Min-sun from Korea taking the gold medal in the women's 1,000 meter sprint from Poland's Iga Wojtasik, with Korea's Park Chae-eun taking third. The first athlete setting down a time that was only beaten by the final athlete in the final pairing. Kim Min-sun is the World University Games Women's 1,000 meter speed skating champion. And we now turn our attention to the men's 1,000 meter sprint. The 1,000 meter sprint consists of 2.5 laps of the 400 meter oval, and it's a race against the clock. So 18 pairs, as with the women's competition. So pair number 11, Petrowski from Poland against Kwon from Korea. Top of the pile at the moment with a new track record is Cho San-hyuk, 1:14.28, the marker to beat. Well, very, very close, ever so slightly ahead is Kwon, but outside the time. But look at that, he's in second position provisionally at the first split. Switching to the inside, powering down now. Kwon takes the shorter inside track at the bell. Still just outside the time, but ever so close, 0.02 of a second between the pairing. But Kwon on the inside track here has a chance just to open things up. They go through the final transition. This is going to be close between the pair of them, that is for sure. Now it's all about what power they can get out of this final bend. They are in the hunt here for top spot. They're certainly both in the hunt for the podium positions. Out of the last bend, and it's the pole who's pulled away, just relaxing off, and look at that. Powers through the final bend, and Jakub Petrowski from Poland and the Academy of Physical Education, Katowice, goes top of the pile. What a final 2:50 from him.
Good job, Poland!
Good job, Poland, indeed. So the track record achieved again. Shige Wataru from Japan and the Senshu University goes up against the USA's very own SLC, Salt Lake City Community College, William Gebauer. And Gebauer getting lots of support.
Go.
Salt Lake City, another hub of winter sports in the USA.
Go.
1:13.64 is the time to beat. And Marashige is 0.65 inside the time at the first split. And look at the ease with which the Japanese athlete glides through the sliding transition and then powers through the bend. And the second inside the time here. Has he got the power through the final two bends? Are the legs still there? But look how quickly the American closes the gap. Gebauer in with a shout here as he switches tracks. Going to the outside, Morishige on the inside here. Morishige inside the time at the first split, coming out of the final bend. A 1:13.64, the time to beat, and it's a 1:12.95 to take the top spot provisionally from Petrowski, and this track record is being absolutely smashed to pieces here. We knew the conditions were good today, but that's the track record being beaten for the third time in this men's 1,000 meters.
Good job, USA! Woo!
Just waiting to see confirmation of where Gebauer finishes up. Drops to eighth in the overall.
And from pair, number 14, on the inner lane, wearing the white armband.
Yamada Kazuya from the Takasaki University of Health and Welfare, representing both them and Japan, goes up against Laval University student, Canada's Hubert Marcotti. So Marcotti on the inside, Yamada on the outside. Pair 16 of 18, doing their 2.5 laps in this 1,000 meters men's sprint. A speed skating event. Day number one here for the speed skaters. Day five of the 2023 Lake Placid World University Games. So we get an indication of how these two are doing at the first split time. So 0.3 outside Yamada, but he's provisionally put himself in second place behind his teammate, Morishige. And as we've seen, the top athletes in this 1,000 meters just get faster and faster. So just easing up over the line, but look at that. Had plenty left in the tank, and Yamada Kazuya from Japan ousts his teammate, Morishige Wataru, from top spot. But we've got two Japanese athletes at the top of the pile now. We see them coming down the final straight, just ducking for the line there, Yamada. Look at that, a 1:12.38. We are 2.4 seconds inside the track record that was held at the start of this competition. So, Nonamuda Taiyo from Japan and Senshu University is going to be paired up with David LaRue. Nonamura in the outer track, LaRue on the inside track. We are coming into the penultimate pairing here, and arguably, certainly by seeding the top four fastest athletes in the field. So through the first split, and both in touching distance, 0.1 and 0.2 outside the split time. So the Canadian pushes on, David LaRue switching through the transition phase to the outer track, still powering through the bend. They get the bell, both still in touching distance. LaRue just 2/10 off the top time. Nonamura coming out of the penultimate bend in the lead, but switching to the outer track. This pair are both in with a shout here. They're looking very strong indeed, powering through the final bend. They are going to be exceptionally close on the line. What about the time? Oh, just outside for Nonamura, who picks Delarue's pocket on the line. But they both move up into the provisional podium positions. Nonamura in second place, and LaRue in third. Literally on the line. And there is confirmation, a 12.50 and a 12.57. How tight was that? Pair number 18, the last of the pairings. Kenya from Poland on the outer ring. Park from Korea on the inner ring. 2.5 laps to complete. A time of 1:12.38 is the one to beat to take the 1,000 meters men's title here in Lake Placid. So through the top bend into the first transition. Not much between them as Kenya switches to the inside track. Park here on the outside, looking relaxed. Ever so close, they get the bell. They're both just outside, but these final 400 meters have proven very, very fruitful ground for the men's 1,000 meter sprinters. Through the back straight, final transition, Kanye moves onto the outside track. He's still got something in the legs. He's powering through this final bend. But look at Park as well. Absolutely stormed through the final bend. A 1:12.38 to beat. They're just outside. Sixth and seventh place, not quite enough for Park and Kanya. So provisionally, we've got Yamada Kazuya from Japan, top of the pile. Nonamura Taiyo of Japan, second place. And David LaRue of Canada in third place. All three of them setting new track records here in Lake Placid. Oh, what a tremendous race from these athletes. Two Japanese athletes at the top of the pile from one Canadian, David LaRue, with a 1:12.57. A very high quality field led by Yamada from teammate from Japan, Nonamura, and Canada's David LaRue. The land of the rising sun shines bright here in Lake Placid.